Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the lead editorial. Now the theme of the lead editorial is food wastage. Now this is the main theme of the editorial. Now the author has written about how the food wastage is done, how we are not able to save the food properly, how we are wasting the food. Now when it comes to the food wastage, we have two categories of nations. Now the first category is the category of the developed countries, and the other category is the category of developing countries. Now when it comes to the developed countries, they have a unique problem with respect to the food wastage protection. And when it comes to the developing countries, they have their own unique problem with respect to the food wastage protection. Now, first of all, what is meant by food wastage and how this problem is unique to the developed and the developing countries? Now, before we understand the problem with respect to the developed and the developing countries, it is important to understand a very important thing, that how the food security issue is gaining importance day by day. Now the why this issue is gaining a lot of mileage and why this issue is gaining a lot of highlight. Now this issue is getting highlighted more because of the burgeoning population. Population itna zyada increase ho raha hai, but jo food production hai, food yield hai, wo bahut zyada increase nahi ho raha hai. So in such a situation, it is important that we should be minimizing this food wastage. Now how this food wastage is peculiar to the developed countries than the developing countries? Now when it comes to the developed countries, it is more related to the behavioral aspect. The behavioral aspect of the people. Now the people, the consumers in the developed countries, वो ज़्यादा फूड को वेस्ट करते हैं. उनका जो कंजम्पशन पैटर्न है, दैट इज़ नॉट राइट. दे एक्चुअली टेंड टू अकमुलेट मोर, एंड अकमुलेटिंग मोर एक्चुअली रिजल्ट्स इन द वेस्टेज. दे आर नॉट एबल टू प्रॉपरली ईट इट अप, दे आर नॉट एबल टू प्रॉपरली स्टोर इट अप. बट व्हेन इट कम्स टू दिस प्रॉब्लम विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज, द प्रॉब्लम इज पेक्यूलियर फ्रॉम द डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज परस्पेक्टिव. यहाँ पे डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज में जो फूड वेस्टेज होता है, जितना हम फूड पैदा करते हैं उससे ज़्यादा वेस्ट क्यों हो जाता है? द रीज़न फॉर दैट इज लैक ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. हेयर द इशू इज दैट ऑफ बिहेवियर, बट इन द डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज विद द इशू ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. वी लैक इन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, द स्टोरेज फैसिलिटी. स्टोरेज फैसिलिटी इज एक्चुअली मिनिमल इन द डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज. एंड सेकेंडली, this is related to the aspect of how agriculture marketing is done in the developing countries. Now in the developing countries, jo agriculture marketing, agar India ka bhi hum example lete hain, India mein bhi jo agriculture marketing hai, till now it was actually confined. Now what is meant by confined? It means that the farmer was not allowed to sell his yield, his farm output, outside the mandi to which he is not registered. Now if he wishes to sell his food grain in some other market, then he needs to register it with that particular market. So it was causing a problem to the farmers. The farmers actually was not able to gain more profit out of the existing, that the practices that was existing in the past. But now the central government is bringing about changes in the Agriculture Produce Marketing Committee Act, APMC Act. Now that APMC Act will be giving away to ENAM. Now what is meant by ENAM? ENAM means that the National Agriculture Marketing will be connected electronically. Now the entire India will be treated like a market. Now in that case, if you have the proper facilities of storage, if the proper facilities of transportation, it means the logistics. Now logistics means that you are able to transfer the food properly from one market to the other, from the seller to the buyer. Now if we work on the logistics, if we work on the storage facilities, the cold storage facilities, and if we allow the farmers to market their products properly, in that case we can work on this food wastage. And along with that, we should also look out for the options whereby we can be using this extra food in order to fill the empty 800 million stomachs 800 million tummies of the people. Now these many people, they sleep hungry every day because they don't have access to the food facility. So we need to understand the peculiarities of the problems, and then we need to understand how we need to revitalize the entire agriculture in terms of logistics, in terms of infrastructure, and in terms of marketing. Now all this will help us to have a situation whereby everybody will have access to the food. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.